Let us enter into a time of prayer. I have a candle lit here. Let me encourage you to do whatever you want or need to do to feel comfortable and centered. Perhaps it's lighting a candle or start with some intentional breathing. Perhaps you want to gather pictures of loved ones. Feel free to pause the video to do what you want or need to prepare to pray. Let us pray. Gracious and holy God, these are days that feel unfamiliar, days that stretch out, days in which life is lived. It may feel like exile, like we are far removed from what is known and familiar and loved. Grant us wisdom, grant us courage, for the living of these days. May we not lose hope, but remain strong in our faith. We pray for those who are lonely, for those who are far from loved ones, and for those who can see loved ones yet long for a hug. We pray for those who are grieving, and there is much to grieve. Help us to feel the love of others and the support and care of this community. Help us to make connections to others and offer support and love. We pray for those who are sick in isolation at home. We pray for those who are sick in hospitals and intensive care units. We pray for doctors and nurses and all medical staff who are providing care. We pray for all who are working essential jobs and feel some measure of risk in their work and in their encounters with others. In a time for spoken prayers or silence, let us continue to pray. Today we remember the events of that first Palm Sunday, a day and the beginning of a week in which Jesus was at mortal risk. Jesus must have had so many emotions on that first Palm Sunday: excitement, love from the support of the crowd, some dread about what could be anticipated, and still he rode on with courage and love and grace. So now, O God, as we gather remotely for worship and praise, for song and prayer, we ask for a full measure of your grace and courage and love. May we rise to the challenges of these days we are experiencing. We ask all these things in the name of the one who came with love and healing and who taught us to pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.